you start doing real bad in school, and then people can't understand, well, why are you doing bad in school? Then when you say, well, your parents divorced, they say, well, what's that got to do with it? That's two different things. Some people think like that. So then it's real hard.
We just broke up, you know, the family just disappeared, and now we hardly ever talk. Nobody's there, you know.
If their parents go through a divorce, if you live through that, you can live through anything. Mm-hmm. You can live through anything.
One of the ways many families try to get through a divorce is by using therapy programs, counseling services like this one that are offered in some public schools. They are designed to help children deal with the emotional agony and uncertainty that divorce can breed. Counties offer counseling as well. Family counselor Karen Schad has seen dozens of children in the Hennepin County program, and it's through people like her that we're trying to learn something about kids of this divorced generation, what they're dealing with that kids in other generations didn't ever have to worry about.
Even family finances was kind of a dirty topic, you know, we didn't talk about money. And kids now, especially during a divorce, are right in the heart of that. They know what the support payments are supposed to be. They know what the mortgage payment is. They're aware of mom or dad's new boyfriend or girlfriend. And in that way, they're going to have a certain level of sophistication that I think maybe kids have not had before.
Most of these kids agree that their parents' divorce advanced their maturity and forced them earlier into self-reliance.
When I hit the age of 14, I got a job. And so when I hit that age, it was, you know, I'm on my own. Something like, I buy all my clothes, I buy all my hair stuff, and you know, toothbrush, toothpaste and all like that. I pay all my bills. And I am very independent.
You know, I have to get home and I have to, you know, clean up the kitchen and do this and do that, and then hopefully have some food ready by the time my dad and brother get home. It's just, I had a lot more responsibility put on me than I would have liked to have. I grew up faster than I wish I would have.
Many young people tell us divorce has strengthened them, that they're more honest with others, that they believe in the institution of marriage and want that for themselves, that they grew from the experience. But the high divorce rate leaves the rest of us wondering what kids are learning from this, if we're sending them signals that commitments were made to be broken, or that family preservation isn't important.
I don't see that in the children that I talk to here. I see them valuing family life and wanting that for themselves in the future. Maybe even the divorce brings about in them a really profound sense of how much it means, how much a secure, stable family life means.
There's a lot to be learned about children of divorce, and it will probably be 20 years before we really know how divorce has affected this generation. In the meantime, many experts agree that how well children come out of a divorce largely depends on how well parents cope with or handle the divorce process. Tomorrow night, a special report on children in the changing American family. Pat?
Good. Thank you, Ann. And we'd just like to remind you that the Project Children documentary series begins tonight with a fascinating look back at the children of the 1960s. It's in a CBS documentary reported by Charles Kuralt called 16 and Webster Groves, and it begins tonight at 12:10 in the morning.
Thank you. Mark Rosen up next on the sports scene.
You can't put food on the American table without the American farm. And you can't have an American farm without an American truck. And Ford is America's truck. Why, you see what I'm...